Hey guys, long time no see. As promised, we have changed our composition of the team for RTA since it doesn't work anymore, and I'm gonna show you today how to run them and how it works in RTA. In this meta, Taranis is the best option for us second turn players. So we're gonna build a team that centers around Taranis, and this team are what I like to call as tank shot, or in other words, bruiser with kill potential. Now in this season, everybody just keeps picking this rider with Bastet, Osiara, Daphnis, the one-shot potential in this meta is very huge. So I could not actually beat this team, and that's why I wasn't able to get to the top. Cause everybody's playing this team, and Vanessa, Triana just doesn't do the job. We're gonna see how this time our well-new tank shot comp is going to do the job for us. Also, my Triana is no longer on wheel. I run her on MS16 instead to counter Daphnis, and I think that's the correct thing to do. See, at this stage, guys, once Vanessa dies, or Triana dies, then we're not gonna come back, right? Whereas Taranis, we have 2 lives, so even if somebody dies, we come back, and then we actually get to do something. Look at that, we put Provoke on the opponent, and waste their turn, right? Whereas Vanessa, after she revives, she just stands there and dig her nose throughout the rest of the game. It's really not that good unless you use Vanessa for first turn. It's all about the speed lead. But for tank shot, it's all about stalling. Yeah, we stall until the opponent is going to die, because obviously they're squishier than us. And we can just stall and come out on top. Look at that, guys. The Beast Rider, who used to just one-shot my Siho or one-shot my Etna, cannot beat these tanky motherfuckers.
Alright, do we really need to use that word?
I also have trouble against CC composition like Hathor, and then a single target stripper like Chiwu. At this moment, this guy, cause not only does he strip, he gives attack buff. That's why I pick Leo over here, is to mitigate their speed, right? But he banned the Leo, of course he did. Put the defense break on my unit, and then try to one-shot everybody. This is the time where Siho Etna just dies. But look at that, everybody is so thick. So thick and juicy, they don't even hurt. And by doing so, we're once again stalling for time. Look at that damage, guys. That thing is a support, goddammit. So how come is it dealing so much damage? And if that had been a Vanessa, she wouldn't have come back and we'd be dead by now. Why is, look at that! She did not die and he took another turn from the Beast Rider. It's too OP, this tank shot. No wonder it's meta. No wonder all the second turn players are playing this comp. Alright, this is the same guy, but since the Dark Yon Hong is not pay to win enough, so he be like, let's try the Dark Jiwoo instead. So this one is more CC, right guys? So that's why I picked Ileana instead of Leo, and Ileana was banned. What's new, right? So with this double immunity, actually we have triple immunity with this tank shot comp, and Vanessa is not landing the bomb. What's new again? But even if he does, then we can just come back with the Forest of Living, and then we'll be under 30% HP. A good time to use Unmounted Harmony, and from the Unmounted Harmony, we follow with the Reckless. That would have killed the Ciara, but Ciara did not land the bomb, so that's fine. We stall even more, and a Fela Jewel with the defense up hurts like a motherfucking truck. The annoying thing about tank shot is that if you're up against another people who use the same strategy, they might take your Harmonia or your Molong, then you need to find a substitute for that. And that's why I need to run my Abelios in case of that happens. And then it's gonna be a game of who stalls the longest.
Ugh.
Now this tank shot comp has a lot of buffs. Harmonia gives buffs, Taranis gives buffs, Fela Jewel gives buffs, so you know what's good against this comp is single target stripper like Diana. But if you bring Diana, all you need to do is get the Antares in, right? And since this guy has at least three nuker, I bring my... Whoa, so ballsy! I forgot this guy actually went for the Harmonia. Like, what the hell, man? And he took the Molong from me. And that's why I've substituted the Molong with something else. Thank God I have the substitute for that. And this is why I need to think about what can I substitute Molong with? Probably Abelios. Probably something like... You tell me. Since the Taranis has defense break, I also go with the first skill for the stun. 50% chance stun, by the way, guys. That is huge. Not only does this guy revive, he provoke and that's a CC. He stuns and that's a CC. Why did Come to Us not nerf him? Oh, that's right, or else there's no way to beat the Beast Rider. That's why. I know I sound very salty in this video because I don't have the Beast Riders and the Beast Riders are just too strong. That's why the nerf was very justified. And as you can see in the previous video, my Josephine was able to stun the Beast Rider and the stun stays forever on the Beast Rider. And don't feel bad about bringing Daphnis into, you know, this comp because even though he's not the tank, he can set up for a reckless kill right there. Doesn't matter if he fails on the defense break, you're still dead. Cause his third skill is going to lower your opponent's HP below 30% and that's all you need. I mean fine, the opponent can just use Wild Roar like 2 times in a row, it doesn't even hurt us. Cause we're fat, we're tanky. And Daphnis not gonna die as long with the soul immunity over there. And by the time the soul immunity wears off, he's gonna have the third skill up again and be protected under the shield. God, I hope this works for next season. I'm also thinking Ganymede would be good for this comp, but then, you know, if I use Ganymede, then the Ganymede is only gonna be there for the Phantolith. Because my Ganymede is gonna be a second turn Ganymede, right? It's gonna be slow as fuck. And by the time the opponent already took their turn, I have no attack bar to reset. That's why Ganymede is more for a first turn player, just that. Whereas Hathor, you can use for this comp, guys. Hathor is never wrong to be in any comp. God, I want a Hathor. If you think Hathor is bad, just wait till you fight Hathor and Savannah. Savannah is like Hathor, just twice as bad. But if I get the chance to pick Taranis first turn, then I'm gonna pick Taranis first turn. Even though it's not optimal to do that. You should go Hathor if you have Hathor. This 2 doesn't have any stripper to go with. I say it's a good time to pick this one first and then Vela Jewel, yeah? No, we go Molong. This way we get to observe what it's going to pick and then we just counter from that. Say if he picks 2 AoE stripper, then I'll probably go Diana or Leo. But if he doesn't, then I will go double immunity. Okay, that's one stripper over here. I can deal with the one shot from this guy. Maybe let's just pick one first, yeah. We pick the Vela Jewel here. Ah, you know what? Screw it. Let's go triple immunity. So if this guy picks another AoE stripper, I'm just gonna ban either one of these 2. And if he doesn't, I'm gonna ban this one. Fine, let's do this. This guy's monster is OP to win though, look at all those dark colors. That's right, you cannot do anything because you can! You cannot reset anything because you can! And you cannot kill anything because you just can't! That's why this is so meta. Do I go for this? Yes, I should because how else my... What's his name? The Vela Jewel is not gonna hurt, right? And it's going to take forever for CC Com ID to kill anyway. Now we put up immunity so that we don't have to waste a turn from the Vela Jewel to kill somebody. That's okay, we just use it early. There's no point in saving it up. By the time we're gonna get low, we're gonna have it again. We nuke her. Now Tank Shot doesn't really have that much kill potential, so I would usually go for the sustain first. What do you guys think? I think that's a correct strategy. We kill a sustain first and then we kill the nuker. I don't know, what do you guys think? I'm gonna practice more with this comp and then I'm gonna go back on that. I'm gonna tell you what's the optimal way to fight with this comp. If I don't use it, I'm gonna get reset by Ganymede next turn. Might as well use it now. Actually, I do not have to. OMG Taku, that was a misplay. You have your Vela Jewel to do the job. This one not scary, this one also not scary. But I'm not going to kill the Dark Demon, right? If I kill him, he's just gonna come back. But yeah, that's the gist of it. This is our new team composition for RTA next season. And from here on out, I'll probably play with this more. So say goodbye to Siho Edna. Well, you guys are probably bored looking at my Siho and Edna anyway. So this, I think, would be a new fresh look on the next season. Okay, these are the runes on my monsters comped. These are the third on, as usual, Fire and Defense. Probably not gonna see much of third. And the Laika, I have him on Will, Phylon, because now he needs to be on Phylon to work. Because he fams now by himself, right? But that means you need to rune him up here also, or else he's not gonna fam that much. Raki, in case if somebody took Ditaranis and I can bring the Raki to fight Ditaranis, then I will. This is my Ciara. Also, same case if I fight another tank shot com, I'm gonna use Ciara. Garo, I don't know why I even put Garo there. Leo, very good against those com like double AoE stripper with no damage. He's on Phylon Nemesis, just a typical tanky Leo, nothing much to say. Here's my Vela Jewel, Will Phylon, and you'll see a lot of build in my Taranis com or tank shot com that has this kind of rune. I mean, that's the gist of it. Antares, yeah, your typical Antares. This the Molong has to be very tanky. And since I'm going second, I'm going to rune him on HP, Phylon Will. Also speed tune with Harmonia, so that he's going to move after the Harmonia, not before the Harmonia. Harmonia also very tanky. My Triana is now on Phylon Nemesis, speed, HP. To counter Daphnis. Because you know, this one, weak against Daphnis. Also weak against Daphnis. Look at our HP, guys. We need to be careful about that. Diana, same build. Mina, yeah, Mina is Mina. Miho is Miho. What is there to say? Tetra has to be on Phylon Will. But for the moment, I don't have enough runes. Because these all are so rune-heavy, hungry monsters. This is my Juno. Ileana. Daphnis. Josephine is now on Will, because I notice if I don't put her on Will, I always get reset by Ganymede. That's not a good feeling. Yeah, this one is the core, right? So I give him my best rune for the defense, speed, crit damage set. Will Phylon, always on Will. Okay guys, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you again in my next video. Bye-bye!